why don't you go and, I mean, any problem, any loneliness can be solved by these four houses, 2, 5, 9, and 11.
Sure.
If you stay with your family, you will not feel lonely. If you stay with your children, you will not feel lonely. If you stay with your guru, you will not feel lonely. If you stay with your friends or your elder siblings, then you will not feel lonely. These four houses have a cure for loneliness. But people sometimes, they think that, their conception of spirituality is so much impersonal. Impersonal means they think that spirituality is some kind of different realm. You know, it can do anything you want. You know, so for example, if you chant some mantras, you know, your loneliness will go away. That will not happen. That will never happen. Similarly, like if you are hungry, if you are feeling hunger, suppose I chant Om Namah Shivaya 1,000 times, will my hunger go away? It will not go away.
No.
Om Namah Shivaya or any mantra will have its effect in a different realm. So similarly, you cannot get rid of loneliness by chanting some mantras or reading scriptures. These things can help you. There is no doubt. But they cannot cure loneliness beyond a certain extent. Yeah. Now, what they can do is, when you go to these four houses, like if you primarily, let's ignore the ninth house, primarily suppose you meet your family, your children and your friends, then primarily what can happen is you may still become materialistic. So the mantras and the reading of the scriptures will help you there. That you try to make your children more spiritual, you try to make your family more spiritual, you try to hang out with a spiritual within spiritual communities. 11th house is communities, you know, spiritual communities, material communities. So the mantras and your spiritual practices will help you there. But if you are feeling lonely or if you're miserable inside, then you cannot claim that, you know, oh, I will chant mantras and I'll become strong and I'll be independent. No, that will make you more miserable. In fact, by that, what happens? You have a false expectation that spiritual practices will make you free from loneliness. And then you'll be so irritated, you will say, these mantras, these are all useless. Throw it away. I will not do all this.
Yeah.
Then I will go to the bar and I will just drink, you know, because that's good, because anyways I didn't get rid of my loneliness. So there is no mantra for getting rid of loneliness or anything like that. Yes, that the mantras can help you to associate better with spiritual people or have spiritual connections with people, by which your overall life improves. Because if you see in the Vedic culture, it is not that they are only focusing on spirituality. It is not like that. Like for example, if you see Jupiter alone, he's a very weird and a very peculiar planet. He's the significator of the second house, which the second and the ninth houses don't have a very good relation, if you see.
Mm.
What is the ninth house? Ninth house is the eighth from the second house.
Yeah.
That is why when somebody does too much spirituality, the family always has a problem.
Sure.
So for the family, it's like death. Death of the family, eighth from the second. So the family says, oh, he will leave us and go. Yes, there are two houses which are not very conducive from the house of family. One is the seventh house. And the other one is the ninth house. And the other one is the Lagna, you. And that is why when we are independent, we cannot stay in a family. We cannot stay in a gathering. Right, so, and seventh house, we all know, so needless to say about family and seventh house, Indians are very well aware of this.
Sure.
So the thing is that in Kali Yuga, what has happened, Jupiter, Sun and Moon, their qualities have gone down. That is why you will see that Shani has become very prominent in Kali Yuga. How do you know that? The easiest way to know about Shani is go to any video in YouTube. Any video, doesn't matter. Just go and check the comments. Out of 10, I would say 7 to 8 comments will be nasty, negative, all dirty jokes. Mm-hmm. They will insult your mother, your father there. They will say all the wrong words they will use without any reason. So what has happened is people have started behaving as if the malefics are like the benefics, which means Saturn is what? Saturn is insult. So people are in an illusion that by insulting another person, my life will become better.
True.
That's why when I go and insult that person, okay, that person's life may be good or better, but my life will not improve by that.
True.
Yes, if I appreciate that person, his life will improve and my life will also improve, because then I can see good things always. So that is what is happening in Kali Yuga, as you asked. The people are not able to see good things. People are only seeing faults, most of the people. And they are always finding faults in people, and they do that with astrology also. Like, for example, you go to anybody, you know, you show them the chart. What will they see first of all? They'll say, oh, your Saturn is in 7th house, marriage problem. Rahu in 8th. Very bad. Depression you'll get. Oh, Mars is in 12th. Terrible it is. So then these malefics will be wondering, where should we sit then?
Yeah.
I mean, imagine if you were given the position of Saturn. You would be more miserable than the people who are being tormented by Saturn, because you have no place to sit. Go to astrology and astrologers or anywhere. I mean, Saturn is bad in the first house. It is Maran Karak. Saturn feels as if he's dying there. Second house, Saturn is bad for the family. You know, there's no family happiness. Saturn is bad in the third house. Maybe it's good because it's Upachya, but still it's bad because it's Saturn. Fourth house, my God, Lord Rama has Saturn in the fourth house. His life is ruined because of that Saturn. And Saturn in fifth house, famous. Mm. From fifth house, he aspects seventh, 11th, and second. So married life is ruined. All the houses of family is finished. Sixth house is anyways a Dustana, so needless to say. Seventh house, marriage. Congratulations, late marriage. And eighth house, again depression. Ninth house, don't get along with your father. 10th house, boss is very cruel, very crooked. 11th house, no money. And 12th house. So there is no house. There is literally no house where Saturn is good, according to many people and many videos. So that's what is happening.
Yeah.
Instead of presenting things in a right way or in a positive way, what is happening is they are like kind of trying to behave as if they are like benefics. So it's like traditionally, if you see, nobody like in my, when I was growing up, like in my family, I would see, like sometimes we would go to some other families, and you know, in my generation, you know, one boy, maybe he's doing something really very stupid, something really very funny, which he should not do. And the father will correct the son. Hey, what you are doing? You should not do this. Yes. But my parents will not join in that. My parents will not tell, hey, why are you doing this? Neither will they do it externally, nor will they think internally. But our generation is not like that. The moment we see some small, you know, faults, we are like, oh, look, this is your fault. You are weak. You are, you know, you are this, you are that. So that's what has happened. The benefics have become so weak that we have started to find happiness with the malefics. That is why we are unhappy, because the malefics are malefics. They cannot make us happy. They can at best make us independent and end up in loneliness, which is happening.
Mm.
All right. So
you want to say that we are focusing more on the bad part in Kali Yuga,
yeah,
rather than focusing on the goodness?
Yes, that is why the three planets, the sattvic planets, their strength has reduced. And that is why people are becoming, like, for example, Mercury and Venus also. Now, if you see in the scriptures, like there is Dharma, Artha, Kama and Moksha, like four pillars are there. So, Artha, like wealth, that's a part of life. Nobody can live without money. You know, everybody earns money. But some people feel that if I make money the goal of my life, then I'll be happy. Well, it doesn't work like that, because who is the Karaka for the 10th house? It's Mercury and he's Asura. So the Karaka for the 10th house can never make you happy. It is these 2, 5, 9 and 11. Only these four houses, they can make you happy. Nothing else can make us happy. So we should try to improve the benefics which we have in our chart. And we should use the malefics to be strong and independent. And then with the help of the benefics, we should try to be interdependent. So that is the solution. So the solution is not that we get rid of the malefics. So the malefics have a purpose. When we use them for the purpose, then life is great.
True.
That is why when, like for example, in ancient times, the kings, you know, when they would become old, what would they do? Oh, enough. We are done. Prince is there. Put him in the throne, and what the king would do? Go to the forest. But the question is, how can a person who has stayed and that those days the lifespan was very long, thousands of years. So imagine a person who has stayed in all royal comforts, opulences, and everybody saluting you. You know, you are eating best of the foods. You know, you have best of the things. And suddenly you go to the forest. My God, what a miserable situation it is. But they would not feel it difficult. Why? Because when they were in the Gurukul, they were in the forest. They had practiced that. That is why now they have no problem. You see. So they were not getting rid of the malefics. They were using the malefics wherever it was required. And they were using benefics wherever it was required. So when they had to get married, then they would not give all this, you know, victory speeches. You know, I am independent. I can stay alone. I don't need anybody. I am strong. I am this. I am that. Blah, blah, blah. And still you are searching about, you are watching Game of Thrones in YouTube. And that's all your independence. You are watching Crime Patrol or I don't know what else. So that is a result. That is an expression of your loneliness, that you are going and indulging in something fancy that does not exist actually. Some fancy stories, you know.
Yeah. This is all a manifestation of Kali Yuga and the Krura Grahas. Yeah.
Yeah.
So what I learned from this session and from your talk is that all the malefic planets and benefics have their own significance. Yes. And we must not try to change their significance. Instead of that, we should navigate ourselves. Yes. And try to keep a fine line between them and try to adapt as per the situation comes.
Yes, use them for their purpose. The malefics, their purpose is to make you strong internally, but they don't make you. And if you use benefics without malefics, you will become dependent.
That is again too much dependent.
That is again miserable. That is like the situation of a person, suppose in a typical scenario maybe. If a man is married and, you know, like he's not maybe independent in himself and he's not happy, he's not content, and he's just going to the office and he's coming and he's just watching TV and he has no idea of what is going on in life. He's totally headless. And then he's telling, oh, my dear, can you please give me a glass of water? And then a wife comes and gives him, oh, this is your glass of water. I mean, that's not what it's supposed to be. So the thing is that the man is supposed to, or he's expected to, maintain the spiritual commitments within the home. Because many times people tell me, oh, actually, you know, if you come to India sometimes, you know, can you please spend 1 or 2 days with my children? You know, and I'm like, why? You know, oh, we think that by staying with you, they will develop some spiritual qualities. And I'm like, I will do that, but that's not my job. That's your job. No, you can always do that. There's no problem. But the thing is, the guru can inspire the person to some extent, but the guru again has limitations. The guru has so many disciples. That is why the responsibility is of the father, because father and the guru has the same house. It's the 9th house. So your father is like the local guru for your house. So it is the responsibility of the man of the house to set the spiritual standards for that house. And he has to do the things first. If he's not doing, he cannot expect that somebody else will do. Now, if he's doing and then also others are not doing, then forget it. And you have done your part, and if they are not doing, then they will go, and maybe one day they get some lessons, they will come back. But it is the prime responsibility of the man. He should set the standards, and he should be doing that. And so that, so in that case, he knows he has used the malefics in the right way. Malefics. He has discipline. For example, every day morning he does his Gayatri, or he does his mantras, or he reads lokas. He goes to spiritual communities. So you require malefics. You cannot just like Jupiter represents all the festivals in India. Like now Navaratri is going on. Everybody is very happy. But imagine these festivals without malefics. Like in Navaratri, there's a lot of malefics are there. Like Saturn is there fasting. So if there are no malefics in these festivals, then it becomes like a playground. That's all. And that's what happens. You go to Ganesh Chaturthi festival, all the movie songs are playing. Or you go to Durga Puja, all the movie songs are playing. But when I was a kid, it was not like that in those days. Everybody, they used to keep a lot of fast, they used to take holiday from their office. And so many things used to happen. So yes, you are right. We should use them to the extent required and only where they are required. And the third thing is we should never, never, never try to extract happiness from them, because they cannot make us happy. That we have to understand. They can make us, like my guru used to say, a sophisticated animal. Like what is if you go to a forest, the lion is running behind the deer and the deer is running. It's like an animal fight. People are running for their life. So in that area, they can give us some sense of fake security. But beyond that, malefics cannot make us happy. It is the benefics which will make us happy. And we should always stay with the benefics and use the malefics wherever required.